If I could, I'm sorry. Oh, congresista O'Rourke, ¿qué haría usted en el primer día, si usted es presidente, sobre esta realidad que está ocurriendo? What would you do, Congressman, day one at the White House?
Vamos a tratar cada persona con el respeto y dignidad que merecen como humanos. We would not turn back Valeria and her father, Oscar. We would accept them into this country and follow our own asylum laws. We would not build walls. We would not put kids in cages. In fact, we would spare no expense to reunite the families that have been separated already. And we would not criminally prosecute any family who is fleeing violence and persecution. We would make sure...
Secretary, let him finish, and I will give you... But let him finish. Let him finish, please. Yes.
We would not detain any family fleeing violence, in fact, fleeing the deadliest countries on the face of the planet today. We would implement a family case management program so they could be cared for in the community at a fraction of the cost. And then we would rewrite our immigration laws in our own image. Free dreamers forever from any fear of deportation by making them U.S. citizens here in this country. Invest in solutions in Central America. Work with regional stakeholders so there's no reason to make
Thank
that 2,000-mile journey to
but
this
we
country.
Have Secretary, I'll give you 30 seconds.
Let's be very clear. The reason that they're separating these little children from their families is that they're using Section 1325 of that act, which criminalizes coming across the border, to incarcerate the parents and then separate them. Some of us on this stage have called to end that section, to terminate it. Some, like Congressman O'Rourke, have not. And I want to challenge all of the candidates
In
to
fact.
Do that. I just think it's a mistake, Bethel. I think it's a mistake. And I think that if you truly want to change the system, then we got to repeal that section. If not,
Thank you.
Then it
so
might as well be the same policy.
Let me respond to this very briefly. Actually, as a member of Congress, I helped to introduce legislation that would ensure that we don't criminalize those who are seeking asylum and refuge
I'm
in this country. If you're fleeing, desperation,
asylum,
then
I'm
I want to make
about,
sure
I'm
I want to make sure that you're treated
else.
With respect.
I'm still talking about everybody
else. But you're looking at just one small part of this. I'm talking about a comprehensive rewrite of our immigration
that's
laws.
Not true.
And if we do that, I don't
that's
think
not,
it's asking
that's
too much
not
for
true.
People
I'm
to follow
about,
our laws when
I'm
they come to this country.
I'm talking about millions of folks. A lot of folks that are coming are not seeking asylum. A lot of them are undocumented immigrants, right? And you said recently that the reason you didn't want to repeal Section 1325 was because you were concerned about human trafficking and drug trafficking. But let me tell you what. Section 18, Title 18 of the U.S. Code, Title 21 and Title 22 already cover
if
human trafficking.
If we apprehend a known smuggler or drug trafficker, we're going to make sure that they are deported.
If you did your homework on this issue, you would know that we should repeal this section.
This is an issue that we should and could be talking about for a long time, and we will for a long time.
Can we talk about the conditions to why people are coming here?
Let's let Lester, Savannah, I know, it's just we could go on.
But rather than talking about specific provisions, we really have to talk about why these people are coming
You'll
to our country
chance.
And what are we going to do to actually make a difference in these countries.
Congressman.